Hi everyone. In this session, we are going to look at Fourier series method. What is this Fourier series method? There are few techniques available in order to design finite impulse response filters. Those methods are Fourier series method, window method, frequency sampling method, optimal filter design method. So all these four are the different types of methods that we can use it for designing a finite impulse response filters. What is the focus provided by Fourier series method? So that is actually the session's importance. Okay. The frequency response of a digital filter is periodic with the period equal to the sampling frequency. So this is actually the concept behind the Fourier series method. Any periodic function can be expressed as a linear combination of complex exponentials. Right. So how can we write the frequency response? The frequency response h of e power j omega of a system is said to be periodic in 2 pi. Okay. From the Fourier series analysis, we know that any periodic function can be expressed as a linear combination of complex exponentials. So the desired frequency response of an FIR filter that can be represented using Fourier series is noted by this equation. That is, HD of e power j omega is equal to the summation of n equal to minus infinity to infinity HD of n into e power minus j omega n. So this is a usual Fourier series representation, okay, where the Fourier coefficients HD of n are the actual desired impulse response sequence of the filter, right? So how to find this HD of n, that is inverse, right? So HD of n is equal to 1 by 2 pi into integral of minus pi to pi, because it becomes finite, right? So HD of e to the power of j omega into e power j omega n into d omega. So this is the formula to obtain HD. Then the next step is to obtain the Z transform of the sequence. What is the formula for calculating Z transform of the sequence? H of Z is equal to the summation of n equal to minus infinity to infinity HD of n into Z to the power of minus n. So this equation is actually a non-causal digital filter of infinite duration, right? So in order to get a filter transfer function, the series can be truncated by assigning a FIR filter, right? So how to obtain a filter transfer function? H of n is equal to HD of n for modulus of smaller value of n is lesser than or equal to n minus 1 by 2, and it is 0 for otherwise. So in that case, how can we rearrange this expression? It can be written in terms of finite values, that is, in summation of h of, what is the value of n here? It takes the value minus modulus of n, which means it is there from the left hand side to the right hand side. So minus of n minus 1 by 2 to n minus 1 by 2 h of n into z power minus n, right? So now we are trying to separate all the, we are trying to expand the sequence and bring this h of 0 because it does not have any z term, and write the remaining terms by taking a common limit n is equal to 1 to n minus 1 into h of n into z power minus n plus h of minus n into z power n. So we are actually talking about filters with symmetric response, right? So for a symmetrical impulse response, the symmetry at n is equal to 0 can be obtained by substituting h of minus n is equal to h of n, or it is the situation where we have h of minus n is equal to h of n. So in that case, this equation can be replaced. So now finally, the Z transform becomes h of z is equal to h of 0 plus the summation of n is equal to 1 to n minus 1 by 2 h of n into z power n plus z power minus n. Whether this is physically realizable now using a filter? No, it is not realizable. So in order to make it a realizable filter, we are multiplying the entire equation by a term called z to the power of minus of n minus 1 by 2, where n minus 1 by 2 is the delay in samples. So finally, h of z is equal to this value z to the power of minus of n minus 1 by 2 into h of z. So h of z is this. So multiply these two in order to get the transfer function of the transform of the function, right. So what are the steps that we have to use in order to design an FIR filter using Fourier series method? So this is actually a quick summary. So the first step is to choose the desired frequency response HD of omega of the filter. Second step is evaluate the Fourier series coefficients of HD of T. This will give you HD of N, that is the target impulse response of the target filter, right? So after that, third step is truncate the infinite sequence HD of N to a finite sequence H of N. Then obtain the Z transform of H of N to get a non-causal filter transfer function H of Z. Final step is to obtain a realizable causal FIR transfer function. How can it be obtained? It is obtained by multiplying this H of Z in the fourth step by Z to the power of minus of n minus 1 by 2. Okay. Thank you.